What's going on, everybody? So a couple of days ago we talked about the first official logo and promotional art for Sony's Venom, and today Sony held their panel at the Brazil Comic-Con experience where Tom Hardy and director Ruben Fleischer talked about the upcoming villain project. And it was there that Tom Hardy confirmed the film will be adapting the Lethal Protector story arc, as that's been the primary inspiration for this version of Venom and Eddie Brock. Now, if you guys don't know, the Lethal Protector arc was one of the most influential arcs, I guess you could say, one of the most popular ones back in the 1990s, that saw Eddie Brock making a truce with Spider-Man and moving to San Francisco, which is essentially the other coast. But he was soon hunted down by the Life Foundation, a group that ultimately transformed into a deadly group of symbiotes. During his time in San Francisco, Venom served as a vigilante, dispensing brutal justice to those who did wrong to innocence. And it was also there that Tom Hardy confirmed that the film does take place in San Francisco, even though it's filming currently in Atlanta and New York City. There have been rumors that the production will move to San Francisco for a few scenes towards the end of the filming date, but we'll have to just see. Now, in addition to confirming the Lethal Protector arc, Tom Hardy did proceed to tell fans that he's trying to do his best to do the character justice and bring plenty of action and dark humor to the role. He also stated that this film will be very important to the upcoming Marvel Universe that Sony is putting together, so it looks like we'll just have to wait and see what's to come. But what do you guys think about this? Are you guys fans of the Lethal Protector story arc? I think it could be certainly cool to see, and it would definitely make sense seeing as this is kind of a standalone Venom story, and I think that's probably the easiest one that you could do without having to reference Spider-Man or anything like that. But who knows, maybe they still will put in an Easter egg hinting that Spider-Man does exist in the Venom universe. We'll just have to see where they take it. But anyways, like I said, drop all your thoughts down in the comments below, and for more updates on Venom and the future of the Sony Marvel Universe, be sure to subscribe to Hybrid Network. Thanks again for checking this video out. If you want to get even more updates from us, check out our social media platforms, our website for the latest news and editorials, and if you want to see our content get better and help us out, donate to us on Patreon for exclusive rewards.